Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to derive the half-angle trig identities, and we're going to use these double-angle identities for the cosine of 2x. So one of them is cosine of 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1, and the other one we'll be using is cosine of 2x equals 1 minus 2 sine squared x. So let's start with this first one. Cosine of 2x equals 2 cosine squared x minus 1. All right, what I'm going to do is try to solve for cosine squared x, all right? So this part right here. So what would I do? One thing I could do is rewrite the equation. So we have the 2 cosine squared x minus 1 on the left side, and that's equal to cosine of 2x. So I'm just switching the order, what's on each side of the equal sign. And now to solve for the cosine squared x, I'm going to add 1 to both sides. So this gives me cosine squared x equals 1 plus the cosine of 2x. And then we would divide both sides by 2. So here we go, dividing by 2. And I've solved for the cosine squared x. Now, I'm going to solve for the cosine of x. To do that, I'll need to take the square roots of both sides. And you have to remember, when you take the square roots of both sides, you have a plus or minus in front of the square root. So on the right-hand side, I'll have plus or minus the square root of 1 plus the cosine of 2x all over 2. Now, this is a little bit tricky. You're saying, how could the cosine of x be plus or minus? Because if I give you a value for x, the cosine of that value is there's only one thing. It's either going to be positive the square root of something or negative square root of something. And that depends on where x is, which quadrant it's in. So you have to choose the sign based on the quadrant that x lies in. Okay, now notice I said I was deriving a half angle identity, and you don't see any half angle identity, but in a way it's there. Notice here I have the cosine of 2x, and over here on the right I have just the cosine of x. So this x is half of this 2x. To see it as a half-angled identity, which is how most people like to see it, we do a little substitution. We're going to let's call this 2x. Instead of calling it 2x, let's call it u. Okay? So instead of 2x, we're going to write u. Then what would x be? If I wanted to divide both sides by 2, I'm sorry, yes, divide both sides by 2, then x would be u over 2. So I am going to replace the x over here with u over 2, which now looks like a half angle, and I'm going to replace this 2x with a u. Okay? So that's the replacement. Where I see a 2x, I'm going to write a u. Where I see an x, I'm going to write a u over 2. And so this formula now becomes the cosine of x, which we're going to write as u over 2. You can think of that as a half angle is equal to plus or minus the square root of 1 plus the cosine of 2x all over 2, and that is a half angle identity for cosine. So what it's saying, whoops, I forgot to replace the 2x with u. I said I did it, but I didn't actually write it. Here we go. Cosine of u. There we go. So what this is saying is if I wanted to find the cosine of half of an angle, I can figure it out if I know the cosine of the bigger angle. So for instance, if I know the cosine of 30 degrees, then I could use this formula to figure out the cosine of 30 over 2 or 15 degrees, right? And that's the idea. Okay, Now let's say I was finding the cosine of 15 degrees. I know that 15 degrees is in quadrant 1. I would choose the positive value. If I was figuring out the cosine of, let's say, 112.5 degrees, that is an angle in quadrant 2, so I would use the negative value because the cosine is negative in quadrant 2. We'll do some problems, actually work through some problems in another video, but in this video I'm just going to derive the formulas for the half-angle identities. So this is the formula for cosine of u over 2. Now you could go back and call that x over 2 or y over 2, it's just whatever angle you want over 2. Now we're going to start with the other formula for the cosine of 2x, which was the cosine of 2x equals 1 minus 2 sine squared of x, to derive the formula for the sine of a half angle. And we're going to do a similar problem, but for fun, let's do our substitution with u first this time. It really doesn't matter when you do it. Remember what we said? We said that 2x was u. And then we said that means that x is u over 2. So you could either do your replacements right now, or you could do it at the end of the problem. To show you that it's okay to do it at the beginning, I'm going to work this out by replacing those values now. So instead of 2x, I'm going to write u. And instead of x, I'm going to write u over 2. And then my goal here is to, and that's not a 4, that is a u in there. My goal is to solve for the sine of u over 2. So it might be easier to just bring that over to the left side of the equation by adding 2 sine squared u over 2 to both sides. So I get 2 sine squared u over 2. And at the same time, I'm going to subtract cosine of u. So this becomes 1 minus cosine of u. All right, now I'm trying to solve for the sine squared first, so I need to divide both sides by 2. Okay, should look similar to that last problem I did. So we'll be able to cancel out those 2s. And then I've got the sine squared of u over 2, so now we could take the square roots of both sides, sine of u over 2, and that means we're going to take the square root of the right hand side, and remember you need to put a plus or minus in front of it. And again, depending on what u over 2 is, what quadrant u over 2 is, that'll help you decide whether you're going to use the positive or the negative value. And when we actually work problems, you'll see how we do that. So now we've got the formula for the sine of u over 2. Okay, so we've done the cosine of u over 2 and the sine of u over 2. As a reminder, this was the cosine of u over 2. We had plus or minus 1 plus the cosine of u over 2. Okay, now remember, the whole fraction is underneath the square root. Okay. So I didn't rationalize the denominator here. This is just usually how it's written. So we've got the sine, we've got the cosine, and now for the tangent, we know the tangent is of x is sine of x over cosine of x. So if I wanted to get the tangent, I just need to put this fraction over this other fraction. So the tangent of u over 2 is plus or minus the square root of, well, actually, let's write down all the steps here. It's the sine of u over 2 divided by the cosine of u over 2. So this will be, now, again, you're not sure whether it's going to be plus or minus, but I'm going to write those in, and depending on where u over 2 is, that again is how you're going to be able to tell where the function is positive or whether to use the plus or minus sign. So we've got, let's see, for the sine, that's 1 minus cosine of u all over 2. And cosine is plus or minus 1 plus cosine of u over 2. And then you have to do a little bit of algebra to simplify this. So if we have this square root divided by this square root, it's the numerator divided by the reciprocal of the denominator, which is actually, and I'm going to just put plus or minus in front of the whole thing, I'm going to have the square root of 1 minus cosine u over 2 times 2 over 1 plus cosine u. And when you put these two together, this is the square root of the whole thing multiplied together, these twos will cancel out, so our final answer here will be just 1 minus cosine u over 1 plus cosine u. That's all under the square root sign, and then we've got the plus or minus sign in front of it. So our three formulas are now, here they are, the sine of u over 2, the cosine of u over 2, and the tangent of u over 2. Now there are actually two other formulas for the tangent of u over 2 that you can use, so I'm going to derive those too, but so these are the formulas we have so far. There's just two other ways of writing the tangent of u over 2. Alright, to get the other formulas, we start off with this. The tangent of u over 2 could be defined as the sine of u over 2 over the cosine of u over 2. And instead of writing those formulas, we could do a little trick here. We can multiply the numerator and denominator by 2 cosine of u over 2. So watch what happens when I do that. So I'm going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2 cosine of u over 2. And so what I really have in the numerator now is 2 sine u over 2 times the cosine of u over 2. And in the denominator, I have 2 cosine squared u over 2. Now, we don't want to go canceling out these because we'd be back to square one. The idea is we actually have two identities right here. You might not recognize it immediately, but the numerator, see how you see like 2 times the sine of something times the cosine of the same thing? So what would that be? Well, that would be 2 times the sine of twice that angle. So the numerator is actually 2 times, I'm sorry, it's the sine of 2 times u over 2. Okay? Now the denominator you might not recognize as readily, so I'm going to alter it a little bit. We know that 2 cosine squared x minus 1 is an identity, but I don't have that minus 1. But how about if I just add 1 and subtract 1? That should be okay. So I start out with plus 1, and I'm going to write plus 2 cosine squared u over 2, which is really there, and then I'm going to go minus 1. So basically, that's still just 2 cosine squared u over 2, right? Because I have a 1 and a minus 1. But hopefully you recognize that this is an identity right here. So that will give me what's happening in the numerator. Well, the 2's cancel, and I have just the sine of u. And in the denominator, I have this 1 plus, and now what's this identity? You recognize that one? That's the cosine of 2 times that angle. So I have the cosine of 2 times u over 2. What will that be? U. So this is an alternate identity for the tangent of u over 2. And notice there's no square roots and there's no plus or minus signs. So if you know both the sine of u and you know the cosine of u, that might be an easier identity to figure out what the tangent of u over 2 is. There's one more formula where we start off with tangent of u over 2, and I already have the steps written out because this video is getting so long. So I can write that as sine of u over 2 over cosine of u over 2. And the trick I'm going to employ here is multiplying the numerator and denominator by negative 2 sine of u over 2, which will give me the negative 2 sine squared u over 2 all over negative 2 sine of u over 2 cosine of u over 2. And in the numerator, the trick I'm going to do here is I'm going to add 1 and subtract 1. Okay, so in the numerator, if I put these together, you can think of that as 1 minus sine squared u over 2, which is a formula for the cosine of 2 times that angle, or cosine u, which you'll see down here, and I still have that minus 1 hanging out at the end. So the numerator, hopefully you see, ends up being cosine u minus 1. What about the denominator? I have a minus sign in front of 2 sine of something times the cosine of the same thing. So that's just the sine of 2 times that angle. And of course, since the angle is u over 2, 2 times that angle is going to be u. So the denominator is minus sine u. So I have cosine u minus 1 over negative sine u, and we're just going to simplify this a little bit by factoring out, see this minus sign in the denominator, I'm going to put that up as negative 1 in the numerator, and then I'm going to multiply that through. The negative 1 cosine u minus 1 ends up being a negative cosine plus 1, or 1 minus cosine u over sine u. Wow, that is another formula for the half angle, cosine of u over 2. Again, there's no square roots. Again, there's no plus or minus signs. So now we have three formulas for the tangent of a half angle, where if you know the cosine and sine of the actual angle, then you can figure out the tangent of half of that angle. So we'll do some problems using these formulas on another video, but for now, let's just show all the formulas derived on this video. So here are the five half-angle formulas, and remember, you could use any letter. I used u. You could have that as sine of x over 2, sine of theta over 2, etc. The idea is if you know the sine and or cosine of an angle, you can figure out the sine, cosine, or tangent of half that angle using these formulas.
Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.